Well, I had my mic muted at the start of that, so that's going to be a couple seconds shaved off of the video. But it's been a while since I've recorded, but since I'm back in Georgia for my spring break, I figured I might as well. I've started using the Great Scythe here. I've only got it plus 7 because I didn't have enough Titanite chunks to go to plus 8 or 9. And I forgot to pick up the ashes in Archdragon Peaks to where I could buy them. Otherwise, I would have just farmed souls and bought them. But since I would actually have to go get those ashes or farm chunks, I've been too lazy. But I'm going to be using the Great Scythe and this glaive, the Black Knight glaive. Really like it. And got my fashion going on after this fight is over, whether I win or lose. I'll show you my build, and this is going to be going up like right after I record it, because it's just going to be a straight recording with like no editing. After this gets uploaded, I'll be working on getting the rest of my second video done. I started a pyromancer playthrough, and I named him Laurentius. I'm gonna be cosplaying Laurentius from Dark Souls 1, that pyromancer, the first pyromancer trainer you can meet in the game, I believe. Oh, you got a little fight club. I don't know what's going on, rightly. They're fighting up here. Okay. No, hold on, no you don't. Oh, no you don't. We do not allow host killing in fight clubs. That right there ain't cool. We're gonna get this boy. He done for. There's a price on his head. I need Black Knight Glaive. Oh. There we go. My fashion is set up to where I can't really use anything else. There we go. Get that out of the way. There we go. And throw on my shield. There we go. Okay. Now I can go back. Alright, well that was a good way to start a fight club. Have the dark spirits go hunt down the traitor. Okay, so who's... Alright, you and you, okay. We shall watch. I think that dude right there wearing Lorien's headpiece, I think that's Lorien's, he's been here longer than me, so he'll probably fight next. But who, oh, we're parried. Ooh, with a medium shield too, unless he swapped out to a Cestus and I didn't notice it. That was good, that was real good. He probably did the weapon art. I wasn't really paying attention, so I don't know what attack that guy threw out. Oh, hold on. I just saw someone with that build. I think I'm in the same fight club as earlier. Okay. I don't know if that guy did the weapon art and got parried or what, but he got parried. Oh, he's got a rapier? That's nice. I wonder if it's the S-stock, the rapier, or... crap, what's it called? Rickard's rapier? You going or you want me to go, dude? You or me? Who's going? Okay, I'll drop in. Alright.
Hey.
There you go. Throw a little bow. Ready? Alright. Oh. That Hornet Ring backstab. See, this guy can just trade a hit with me and win. I can't. Oh man. That sucks. Ah, well, I mean, the entrance to the fight club was great, but that fight, man, I really screwed up that. Oh man. I got wrecked. Alright. Man, that's great. Just to note, I haven't been in Georgia for very long. I've been in here, been in Georgia for like all of, let me check time, not even 12 hours, so, oh no, not even 24, I mean, it's been like 18. But I've been playing Dark Souls for probably 4 hours, and two of which were PvP, so I got warmed up a little bit. I'm not sure if I'm gonna edit this out yet, speeding this up, but my build, or my stats is this. This is one of my old characters that's only 90, or level 99, and it's a quality build. I'm wearing the Knight's Ring, so that boosts my strength. So my actual strength isn't that level. I've got Hood of Prayer, Lorien's Armor, Black Knight Gauntlets, and Knight Leggings for my fashion. Then I got Hornet Ring, Knights, Ring of Favor, and Claranthe. The only reason I have a Hornet Ring equipped is for the occasional R1 spammer. It's also the reason why I carry a Iron Round Shield. I used to use the Cestus all the time, but I heard something about how, it's... I don't want to use the word OP, but just how the animation has more parry frames than it should. There are more parry frames than animation length. Ooh, that partial. Alright. This boy wants a parry. Yep. He's gonna be going for parries. Alright. Oh, he got it. Am I gonna die? No. Alright. I got one of these people. That's cool. Alright. Oh, he dual wielded the Cestus. Okay. Taking my time with this dude just so I can try and win and show how parrying all the time isn't the way to go, even though I sometimes do that. Dang it, bad trade. I can't trade. I don't know. Very well, GG. Yeah, well, what is it? Fair enough. Just ignore background noises. Oh, this mic's a bit too sensitive. It picks up like everything within a 20-foot radius, because I'm kind of in an open room. I mean, it's off separately, but there's no like a door to close it off. There's not even a doorway. It's just like a downstairs area that I'm in, so everything on the floor up above you can pretty much hear. I don't know, should I talk about Laurentius, my new build? I don't know, I don't want to spoil anything that might be interesting in that video. I had a really great start, I think. Well, I mean, it took me like 4 tries, but I got a really great cheese on a Gundyr with my Pyromancer. It's pretty good. I think I improved over my span of not playing. I just came back and I had my timings down pretty well for parries. Or at least AI parries. Like all the AI enemies I was doing pretty good on. The only people I've parried in PvP were R1 spammers, which I've only parried like one of. Because, I don't know. I don't know what it is about my character. It just I used to be able to face tank, but now I cannot face tank. It doesn't work. I'll just die. Alright. I'll be honorable. There you go. Alright. Got a katana. Is that a washing pole? Maybe not. I don't think that's a washing pole. Might be the Uchi. Alright, if he's gonna just do running attacks, I'm gonna show him what's up. Maybe not with that, but I'll show him what's up. Alright, screw parrying. I cannot trade. It's just not a thing I'm allowed to do. Nicked him, apparently. Oh, I did not roll in time. Okay. GG. Those katana running attacks. I need to get used to those again, I suppose. It's been a while. Very well. Well, I've only got one quarter left in my junior year of high school, so when that ends, we'll see what happens next as far as my gaming hobby goes. Is there anything I want to change? Nah. Scythes are like, I don't want to call them skill weapons, because, I mean, it really doesn't require all that much skill. I mean, maybe a little bit more skill than a Dark Sword or something, but the only bothersome thing about them is the amount of damage they do. I mean, I've only gotten mine +7, but even if it was +9 or +10, I don't think it would be doing enough damage to really keep up with other things, which is why I have the, what's it called? Black Knight Glaive. In fact, do a couple more duels with Scythe here, and then I'll swap out to the Glaive. I might change up my fashion, or I might just throw on Havel's ring. This looks interesting. Ooh, I don't know if that's my connection or his. Or hers, I suppose. Alright. Ooh, no, I can't trade. Alright, well, this is a, like an intelligence build, so it's not going to have quite as much health, which is useful for me and my slightly lower damage. That was a great, great spacing, Robert. Great spacing. Oh, I should probably talk about why I changed my channel's name. I changed it to Gaming Sociopath as a kind of a joke, not really a joke. I was doing just random little personality surveys on the internet just because I was bored one day, and I have like pretty much every trait of a sociopath except for the fact that I don't try and manipulate people. I mean, if I'm playing a prank on somebody, I mean, sure, I'll lie to them and coax them into something, but I mean, that's about it, and that's standard with the pranks. So I'm gonna blame that failure on me talking, but it wasn't me talking that got me killed, it was just poor playing. So that's great. I really miss playing this game. That was a really good game. Oh, I got the DLCs. I bought the season pass, so I won't be able to play Ring of, or Oh crap, what's it called? The Ringed City. I won't be able to play The Ringed City because I'll be back up in Tennessee before that comes out. But I have Ashes of Ariandel, and I intend to beat that in before I go back to Georgia. Or, I mean, back to Tennessee. So, there is that. And I hope I'm talking loud enough for, this. Like, I can never tell. But hey, that's whatever. Can I throw on... Oh, I can't. Black Knight, Dark Hand, Armor of Thorns, Nameless Train. Nice. Too light. I was changing up my fashion so I could throw on that glaive later, and so I can hold a sorcerer staff, because just one of the little things I decided to throw into my build was the ability to use chameleon, which fashion ought to be good for now. That'll do fine. I might edit that later, but it'll be good for now. Is that the same guy? No, don't think so. Looks familiar to someone I saw earlier. Are you summoning people or are you coming down, bro? Come on. He blinked. Alright, there we go. There we go. Let's go. I pretty much judge the difficulty of a fight based off of how much damage I do on the first hit, or how much, like, what percentage of their health I take on the first hit. Because the more health they have, the more difficult it'll be for me. And I've been having a problem with Phantom Range lately. Like, Phantom Range seems outrageous on some of these weapons. I don't know if it's latency or what. I was hoping he'd roll in. Oh, okay. There you go. This weapon's got a pretty good roll catch for a one-handed R2. Oh, and I can roll into him. The disrespect, let's go. No, okay, no disrespect. There you go. There you go, the disrespect. There you go. I love thorns. It's so funny. So fun to mess with people with it. I can't remember if quick stepping into someone with thorns hurt you. I think it does. I remember at one point there was the Karthus blood ring, and then full thorns armor was like a meme. But I don't remember if they used quick step or if they just rolled. Hmm. How's that look? My fashion. Looks alright. If I really want something thorns, though, I'd probably do it with the gauntlets rather than the legs. But that looks alright. I just kind of feel like I need that hood for all ominous spookiness of having a Sith. And yes, I actually know it's pronounced Scythe. I was just saying it incorrectly just cause. Drake blood armor, that might look nice. Really heavy, but it might look nice. The Lucerne. I think I tried out the Lucerne at one point. Don't remember if I liked it or not. I'm not sure how long I've been playing with a scythe, so I'm gonna go ahead and swap out to the glaive. I can still medium roll, so that's good. Oh, this guy looks familiar. I fought someone like this earlier in the day. I don't remember if this guy is the same or not. Yeah, Bao is. That looks like Outrider armor. Hope I'm not wrong with that. That looks like the Outrider armor. Alright. Oh, crap. Alright. I didn't remember hyper armor giving you higher defense. I didn't remember that. That rolling R2, is that R1? Oh no. Oh, if he'd have continued that, I would have been dead. Okay, alright. Fat roll? Is that, that's fat rolling, it's gotta be. I mean, he's not like hitting the ground hard, so it must be like a low fat roll or something. This is the first time I've killed someone with a weapon art of the Black Knight glaive. That's not bad. That was a good fight. I would have been dead if he'd, had enough stamina to continue that other thing where he would have picked the sword back up and put it over his back. I'm not sure if he didn't continue it or if he just didn't have enough stamina, but either way I got lucky. So that was pretty nice. Talisman. I was considering a faith build one time, and then I decided that I wasn't really into the faith builds. I wanted to do a pyromancy build in Dark Souls 1, but I could not play a pyromancer in Dark Souls 1, and I'm finding pyromancer to be a lot more difficult in 3, but I'm probably just playing it wrong. I don't know. Hand axe just does so little damage. Well, I mean, if you create a quality build or something for the hand axe, you can get pretty decent AR out of it, but with investing mostly in intelligence and faith and not strength and dex, it's not the best. But since I'm doing a Laurentis cosplay build, I'll be using I think I'm gonna go with Chaos for the hand axe. Either Chaos or just fire, but I'm not sure. I'm gonna have to look up the scaling on those gems, because I have a fire gem on that character, and it didn't put any scaling on faith and intelligence on the weapon. It just left it with no scaling, so I don't know if it'll scale even though it says no scaling, or if it just stays as is and just goes up as I upgrade the weapon, or if it doesn't go up at all. But hopefully they scale. I'd have to do a little bit of research, because I don't use elemental infusions. The only thing I do is refined, heavy, and sharp, pretty much. that an exile? Haven't seen you. Hello, old friend. You like the Black Knight glaive? Is that too meta for you? That exile greatsword's pretty meta, so. Good old. I remember the spin to win combo on that. You coming down, bro? Coming down. Oh! Oh, it's. I didn't even see this guy. My bad. Is he wearing a obscuring ring? I don't know. I'm blind. Let's go. I think this guy wants to parry me, like, really badly. Oh, that was a bad idea. Okay. Fair enough. GG. I forgot to check, when I started recording, because this, since I'm on PS4 and just using Share Factory as my recording and editing software, I just hit record for 30 minutes, and after 30 minutes it's supposed to shut off and save the clip, so I don't know when it's supposed to shut off, so it'll probably cut out at some random point, maybe even in the middle of a duel, and then, I'll just add another clip onto that, doing my outro, even though I don't really have an outro. It'd just be saying, like, bye, thanks for watching. It'd pretty much be it. Pretty active, community here in Dark Souls 3 still. At one point I heard that it was dying, but it seems like people are still around. I mean, I'm in the lower level areas. Well, not really. I'm in the 95 to 100... 105 range, something like that. So, slightly lower than the meta, but not by much. I'm debating if I need to edit out those usernames or not. I don't think it matters. I'm not popular enough for anything that happens to really be a bother. They just be like, oh. Does this need to... Let's put an end to this boy. That boy thinks he can just interrupt a fight club, apparently. Let's go. Let's go. Some people just want to kill the host. I don't know if that guy invaded, so he was just doing his job as an invader, or if he just wanted the host dead. Alright. Where's host at? Oh. Wait, this is the same host as earlier. That's the same host that, helped out a second ago. Or not a second, it was a couple minutes, but you know. You gonna come over here and watch the duel? No? Okay. Oh, that parry. Is that the same person? I think that is. It's gotta be. It's gotta be like the host's friend or something. Ooh. See, what is that? I can't. It looks like, Sellsword Twin Blades. That, the L1 L1 combo, or L1 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 combo is devastating. And, just as I had predicted, the, video randomly cut out. But that's fine. This is gonna be probably closer to a 40 or 50 minute video, depending on if I decide to cut out a fight or two, but I think I did a pretty good job of commentating throughout, so I'll probably leave it unedited. I don't know, English. And we'll live or die in this fight club, and then that'll be the end of it. And if I start doing really good in this fight club, then I don't know. I might go up to closer to an hour, who knows. I just want to get a win with the Black Knight Glaive, because I don't think I have yet. No, I did. I think. I don't know. I've actually got a couple extra PvP clips that I want to throw into this video that I captured earlier recording, so this will probably be like an hour long video. So, I mean, oh, if you watched to this point, comment Doogie in the comments. Just put Doogie. D-O-O-G-Y. Put that in the comments. That point down, though, that's pretty sick. Is he out of Estus? Alright, that's cool. Oh, somebody just got backstabbed. I don't know if that was an accident. Okay, well, let's take care of this. There. You call those wins? I don't know. Come on, somebody come down here and fight me. Do a little bow. Yes, yes, yes. Let's go. Let's go, boy. This looks actually like a job for the scythe with the shield chip damage I get. I might try and backstab this dude. I don't know. Never mind, he's gonna backstab me. Okay, that's fine. That's cool. Oh, I did not think it'd reach. There we go. Crap, I should have rolled. At least I got that backstab revenge. That was good, that was good. GG. Alright. I think that'll be the end of it. Yeah, that other phantom that showed up was same guy as earlier, so definitely one of the host's friends, I'd imagine. I don't know if he keeps putting on a password and taking it off, or if he just puts his summon side, like, in a corner somewhere where most people don't put theirs, so he can be separated. But, that's about all for this video. Thanks for watching, and, enjoy the extra clips that'll get tacked on to the end, and, I'll see you in that, Laurentius cosplay video. I'm not sure, when it'll come out. It actually might come out a couple days from now, depending on how active I am with getting clips for it, but thanks for watching, and see you whenever I make another video. Okay, I wasn't originally going to commentate over this, but I just kind of felt like I needed to explain what's going on here in case people don't know. But the person I'm dueling right here in this bonus clip, and I had less bonus clips that were worthy of being shown than I thought I did, but in this bonus clip, I'm fighting a giant dad cosplay, and it's the best one I had ever seen in Dark Souls 3 because most people either I hadn't seen very many to begin with, and then the ones I had seen weren't all that great. This one was pretty good. Like, you know, as far as working with what you had that's in Dark Souls 3 at the moment, this is pretty good for Giant Dad. And I tried to parry the Zweihänder earlier, which was kind of stupid. I don't even know why I bothered trying to do that. But yeah, that, like, props to this guy for trying to do a Giant Dad build, because if he's actually got a Chaos Zweihänder, like, props, big props, because split damage kind of sucks in this game. And I clapped because, I mean, it was a good cosplay. I didn't want him to die. I mean, the legend never dies. I just wanted him to live, but he had accepted his fate, I suppose, and wanted to finish the job or get finished. So I killed him, and then I collapse in sadness for the legend, but the legend never truly dies. I ended up messaging that dude and telling him I thought he had a great cosplay, but other than that was it. There's one more bonus clip, and thanks for watching. This bonus clip right here, I don't win, just spoiler alert, I lose, but it was such a good fight, I just had to include it. I mean, me and this person were going at it for 3 minutes. I mean, like, it was a good fight. I lost, but I thought it was a great fight. So, hope you enjoy, and I'll see you in the next video.